Greetings, everyone. Welcome back. Previous video, we did all the animation inside of the animation level sequence, which is a subscene that we added to shot 04. We talked about how we could have an animation subscene, we could have an effects subscene, an audio subscene, whatever other subscenes you want that will ultimately comprise shot 04 layered on top of one another, and how each member of your team could work in their own individual subscene without affecting the overall shot, without working within the overall shot. We talked about that. We also fixed the root motion issues with our bear and the translation that occurs between animations. So we fixed those. So our scene is pretty much done on the animation from the animation perspective. Now we just need to go in and set up our cameras. So now we're taking the role of the cinematic designer, the person that's going to come in and frame each shot. So we're going to continue, and we're going to work inside of shot 04. Before we do that, though, I did want to mention one thing. If we take a look at this here, so we're inside the master level now. We have our shot 4 here. Actually, if we play shot 1, shot 2, and shot 3, they play as expected. However, when we get to shot 4, we don't have any cameras yet. But if we look at our default viewport, the animation starts over. Now, this is an issue that I know that our team is currently working on with respect to how the marker translates with subscenes and shots. So for example, we're at frame 468 here. If I jump into shot 04, you would expect that it continues from 468 inside of there. However, it goes back to the beginning. If we were to go to frame 468 here, it goes to the end of this, which is not what we want. But if we jump, if we're at 468 and we go into our animation subscene, it continues where we want to actually continue from. So what we can do for this, actually, let's go to 468. We can use the left closed bracket. We've been using the right one quite a bit, but we're going to use the left closed bracket now. And if we press that on our keyboard, this is where we will start the scene from now. So we're not really paying attention to any of that stuff that came before it. And if we hop back up to the master level now and scrub through, it will continue on as we would expect. So now for shot 04, we can come in and place our cameras and do what we want. And then we could do that for shot 5, shot 6, shot 7, and shot 8, which will be our last shot. So let's go ahead and do shot 04 now. I'm going to jump into shot 04. And we're going to leave the animation track. Should play all the way through. Perfect. So now we can go back to the beginning of this. And as we've done before, we can click our create camera button. So I'm gonna click this. And it's gonna create the camera for us and do all that good stuff. We need to change the film back settings. I'm gonna change that to 20x12. Gonna hit Control S to save that just in case. We're piloting that camera now. And for this shot, well, now we're not piloting, but now we are. For this shot, I'm actually gonna use this perspective. I'm gonna maximize this for a second. I'm actually going to use this perspective to frame it up something like this. Let's see. Let me get this back, actually, and see what this looks like. Yeah, that thing is in the way. I went too far back. So we'll kind of pitch down, maybe, coming through the rafters. Something like that, because the bear is going to walk from right to left. So I think this is good. We'll do this. This is fine. Let's go. Make sure our camera is selected. Let's add the transform for this. So I'm going to hit S. Scrub ahead a little bit. And we're actually going to cut before he performs a strike. So when he gets to the end of his walk, right before that pop happens, little pop, maybe right there, 139 it looks like. I'm going to right mouse button, W to move forward. I'm also going to pitch it over just a little bit, something like this. I'm going to hit S, see what that looks like. That doesn't look bad. Ah, we lost our camera. It's going to look something like that. And let's also make sure that we're focused on this. So let's go. We can also see the path of our camera here. That's the path that our camera takes. Let's go ahead and let's go to our focus settings, eyedropper. I'm gonna click them and just add a keyframe for that at the end. I think that's good. So now if we go up to the master level, and we look at shot 4. Did it save it? Yeah, it did. Let's double check that and jump into shot 4. It's not all the way connected. That's the problem. Make sure that they're lined up and connected. Otherwise, if you have that gap like I just did, you're going to have a space in your cinematic. So let's go ahead and make sure that that's lined up. Now it should be seamless. That looks good. All right, so we have, let's just play from here. And kind of pushes in. Little bit of sliding at the end there, but we're gonna cut anyway. So really, that's it. This is gonna be a short video. That's shot 4 in the books. We're gonna do shot 5 and 6 together in the next video to show you how you can continue on, and then we'll do 7 and 8 in the video after that. Feel free to use your own shots if you'd like. Set up your own cameras and skip ahead to, I believe it's gonna be video. It's gonna be video 11, I guess. If you'd like to skip ahead. Otherwise, continue watching and we'll finish the rest of the shots, try to get through them really quickly. It's going to be a lot more of the process that we've been doing. We'll try to get through them as quickly as we can. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next video.